very nice Japanese style dessert, tea room, and enjoy great afternoon tea and desserts. Now we're about to go to the same restaurant we had dinner. It's called Jelly. Right across in the hallway is called the Sichuan Mountain House. So yesterday I really want to try both, but I was so intimidated by the menu here, so we actually stayed the whole dinner here. They're so cute. But today for lunch, we're gonna go back to this restaurant, have some soupy dumplings, which was excellent, and another dish I didn't get to order last night for dinner. And we're gonna go across the hallway to this Sichuan Mountain House and have some of my favorite Sichuan dishes. Let's go inside. Here. The music played is so familiar. Food was excellent from last night. That's why we came back today. So this restaurant is a Shanghainese style restaurant. So this is our appetizer. It's marinated daikon and soybean. And the music at the background is a very famous Suzhou Pingtan, Suzhou opera. My dad used to play for us when we were young, so it's such a familiar sound. So for lunch, we have only ordered the soupy dumplings and xiefen doufu, which is crab, meat, and tofu. Here comes our soupy dumplings. I'm so excited. So to make it up, you can't break it, because if you break the skin, then all the best soup inside is gonna lost like that. So now to demonstrate how to properly eat the soupy dumplings, you pick it up and you have to be very gentle and you peel the skin. Hang on. Slowly from the bottom, because if you do it too fast, you're gonna break it. There you go, the full thing intact. And the way to eat it is you have to bite a very small hole on the top, hang on. Let the heat out and then suck all the juice out. And then pour some sauce on it. That's it. You're still. Alright, so this is the second dish that I really wanted to order last night but didn't because we got so much food already. This is xiefen doufu, crab meat tofu. Alright, let's dig in. So that was delicious. Now we're going right across the hall to this mountain house, Sichuan Mountain House. Beautiful decor here too. Smells great. Check out that ceiling. Alright, let's see how the foods are. Alright, so the menu here looks pretty enticing. We have to make a decision of what we want to order. And for appetizer, here's the spicy cabbage marinated. Very interesting. And then some tea to start. I love those cups. It's almost see-through. Look at that.
I thought I was gonna put something else in there.
So I'm pretty obsessed about the scene and how they did it. It's so beautiful and very interesting.
paintings are also very classic Chinese 水墨画, just ink painting, simple but yet elegant. Sophie is fascinated with this teacup.
It looks absolutely beautiful.
And the background music is actually guzheng, a very traditional Chinese instrument. Alright, so this is the traditional Sichuan dish called la ji. So basically fried chicken in the midst of all the chili peppers and peanuts and scallions. Alright, so this is a very interesting serving dish. It's literally a shovel. Very creative. Okay, so it looks like a big dish, but the way you eat it is you pick out those chickens and enjoy this and leaving all the chilies on the plate. Or you can bring those chilies home and make a different dish out of this. So the Sichuan dish has a very famous spice and create a very unique and insane sensation. It's spicy and numbing. It has a very special effect on your tongue, like Sophie's experience right now.
The entire pepper.
Oh no, she just ate a whole entire Sichuan pepper. Alright, here's the second dish just arrived. This is the dumplings in the red chili oil. So now we have tried both places, the Sichuan food and Shanghainese food for lunch. What is the conclusion, Sophie?
Both prefer the Shanghainese one.
That's right. The Sichuan style, just a little too spicy for us. So here you have it. If you're ever visiting in New York, you should try these two places.